Some of the best boxers I have met have been in private life the quietest, most gentlemanly fellows with a self-respect which begets respect for themselves in others. Be one of these. These are the words of Andrew Darius Jephta, the South African boxer who became the first black British welterweight title holder in 1907. The book itself talks about his glorious achievements, but is also more complicated than that. It talks about the struggle of a blind man, in addition to an incredible state of awareness that Jephta himself encountered in relation to race, as he moved from South Africa when it was a colony of Britain, eventually returning when it was a union. The book that I hold in my hand is in fact the only known copy in existence, and yet it is such an important document, both to Andrew Jephta's tenacity and in relation to the broader changes that was taking place in South Africa and internationally at the time in relation to race. It is therefore not simply a record of sporting achievements or a record of damage, but offers in fact a rich understanding of the power of text and how Jephta imagines this text would circulate even beyond his own life. The intriguing thing about Jephta's text is that it does not speak about blindness as a disability, but rather the collateral damage of a professional who took his risk at the highest level of the sport. Jephta himself spoke about many challenges that he faced, including the incredible social way that he was read in relation to race. In France, he was known as Le Nigre. In Ireland, he was called the Boer. What's really intriguing about the book itself is that it offers many accounts of his battles. The most glorious one was his 1907 encounter with Curly Watson, which really earned him the title. It really is a courageous story in the sense that Jephta faces Curly Watson for the third time after being defeated on two consecutive occasions in order to get the title. His nose was broken and his ears and eyes were bleeding already early on in the match, but he refused to give up, and eventually he received his reward and was crowned the welterweight champion. The book itself was sold next to the flower sellers in Adderley Street, and we know it was published in 1910, at a time when Jephta was facing severe poverty and had left three of his children and his wife, Abby Mitchell, in London.